Thank you. Thank you. Hey, sorry. Do you mind if I sit here while I wait for my coffee?
Oh, yeah, knock yourself out.
Oh. Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry.
No, don't worry, it only spilled a little.
I'm such a klutz. Is your sketchbook okay?
Yeah, unscathed. It's just doodles anyway.
Can I see it?
Oh,
Oh, this is a cool castle.
Thanks. I just started drawing again. I used to sketch constantly, and then, I don't know, I just stopped.
So did I. I mean, there was a time in elementary school when I was the girl who was good at drawing.
The girl who was good at drawing? I remember that girl.
Everyone was always like, oh, please, will you help me with my poster?
How do I draw hands?
Exactly. I was like, I don't know how to draw hands. I'm 5 years old.
Well, let's see how far you've come since your toddler years.
Okay.
You're drawing in it upside down.
Hey, there is no right or wrong way to draw in a sketchbook.
Okay, that's fair.
Oh, wow, that's my order. That was fast. I'm Kenzie, by the way.
I'm Michael.
It's nice to meet you. I just gotta run.
Bye, Kenzie.
think I know your face, your smell, the beat of your heart against mine. But oh, there's no escape, 'cause you're here to stay. Goodbye to the day I'll hide in my dreams, wrapped up and tied away.
you smell that?
Oh, I smell it.
Now this takes me back. Welcome to the fair.
Not how I pictured it.
What did you imagine?
You saw my drawing, you know, circus tents and stuff.
Well, a county fair is nothing like a circus.
I know, but I don't know. I just kind of assumed.
Hold on, your parents never took you to the fair?
No, we went to Disneyland.
Oh, you are going to have to set your bar 1,000 times lower. Think like a farm, but with a lot more deep fried stuff. And tube tops. And $20 beers.
Will they at least have a Ferris wheel?
Okay, yeah, that is the one thing you sketched that we probably will see here. But it won't look like the janky one you drew.
Really?
No, it will be even jankier. I mean, these rides, they're death traps, and that's all part of the thrill.
Tube tops, $20 beers, and death traps? That's setting the bar plenty high for me.
You want to try this fortune-telling machine?
I don't know.
What, you don't like these?
I'm not superstitious, but if I get a bad fortune, I feel like it's some kind of doomed, self-fulfilling prophecy.
These things don't give bad fortunes.
Not necessarily. When I was a kid, one of those things told me my pet turtle Pinky would die, and she did.
Well, unfortunately, that is part of the turtle life cycle. They do die.
It was a Galapagos turtle.
No, it wasn't.
No. But she did die a few days later.
Okay, we don't have to do it.
No. Just because I don't want to do it doesn't mean you shouldn't. Go for it.
Okay.
What does it say?
Nothing.
Michael?
I guess they do give bad fortunes sometimes.
Huh.
Yeah, you were right.
Thank you.
here it is.
Wow, this place is great.
Isn't it?
What do you call it?
Just the secret spot, I guess.
I've walked past here a million times. I never knew this was here.
I don't think anyone does.
Wow, you can see the street from here.
Yeah.
They have no idea we're up here.
You do know what the word secret means, right?
Oh, come on. You don't think anyone knows about this?
No, I put that little guardian owl in there.
Oh, so he keeps it safe?
No, dude, he's made of wood. I just think he'd be gone or vandalized if anyone else had been here. I really think I'm the only one who knows.
Well, now two people know.
I've never shown this place to anyone, Michael. You're the first.
I won't tell anyone.
Promise?
Pinky promise.
Okay, I need to run to work. You've got the address for tonight?
Yeah. When should I get there?
Well, my roommates are kicking things off at 7, but my shift isn't done till 9. But if Aaron shows up, I can get out at...
So what time should I get there?
Get there when you get there. If I'm not there, just introduce yourself.
Great. I'll see you then.
Thank you. you are.
Hey.
How long have you been here?
I was just about to ask you the same.
Who are you talking to?
One of your friends, tall, pale, heavy eyeliner.
Guy or girl?
Girl.
Oh, Anne. She's not my friend. She's a friend of a friend.
But still a friend.
Oh, yeah. Love her. But I want to introduce you to my really close friends.
Well, Anne gave me a whirlwind tour of introductions already.
Oh?
Yeah, and they all knew who I was.
Oh.
Yeah, I am, quote-unquote, Kenzie's bestie. Your roommate Tom actually insisted that I have been your coworker for 2 years.
Oh my God, Michael, I'm so sorry. That's so embarrassing.
Kenzie, I am not good with... Can we go somewhere to talk?
Yeah, my room's down here.
You know, I'm not good with things like making moves or whatever, but I didn't think that... We're not just friends, are we?
Michael, look, I'm not good with making moves either. I mean, I'm way better than you, but these last couple weeks, honestly, I feel like I'm in a dream pretty much the entire time I'm around you. And no, we're not just friends.
Thank you.
What?
I think I love you.
You think?
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
What do I say back?
You can say, I love you too.
Well, you didn't say I love you. You said, I think I love you. And you want me to just straight up say I love you back?
You don't have to do anything.
You're trapping me.
I'm not trapping you. I'm expressing my feelings.
With a qualification.
Michael, I'm just saying that I think...
You think.
What do you want me to say?
You don't have to say anything. I don't want you to say something that you are not ready to say.
But I do want to say it. Okay.
I love you, Kenzie.
I love you too. Michael.
Thank you. sunflower.
Hey.
You know what I want?
What?
A landscape fridge.
I don't know what that is.
I just invented it. You know refrigerators? They are tall and narrow, so there's this bottom shelf of stuff that you have to bend down to and pick through to see what's there, and so you never do. It's horrible.
Chilling.
Ha! But imagine a fridge, same size overall, but countertop height, laid out horizontally. Everything is accessible right there. No bending down.
You nerd.
It makes sense though, right?
Yeah, but where the hell are you going to put it? It's not going to fit in our kitchen.
Hey, this is our dream kitchen.
Oh, well, you know what I want?
What?
A dream house to go with this supposed dream kitchen of yours.
Well, duh.
No, but you know what I've always really wanted? A grandfather clock.
Yeah, but those things are loud. I mean, they're totally impractical for a place in the city.
Yeah, but I always pictured settling down somewhere outside of the city.
Oh, really?
On a few acres near some woods, quiet and out of the way, where it snows in the winter, but not too much.
Uh-huh.
The big tree in the yard.
Wait, okay, can you throw in a few more cliches there, like maybe a picket fence and a dog and a cat? Oh, maybe 2.5 kids?
Hey, this is a dream house, remember?
I know.
But yeah, I like that, a dog and a cat. Michael.
That was a nice ceremony.
Yeah, I liked the giant goblet they drank out of.
I'm glad she didn't have a veil.
Why?
I just feel like the veil, the death to us part, it feels very haunted, very ghosty.
I like ghosts. I'm actually very excited to be one.
Ooh, when you die, where do you want to haunt?
When I die?
Yeah, when you're a ghost, where do you want to haunt?
I guess I want to zoom over the ocean really fast.
Really? Which part of the ocean?
The whole ocean. I just want to zip around with my arms spread out. I don't want to haunt anyone in particular. Just the whole sea.
Ah, scaring sea creatures and seagulls. Interesting choice.
Where do you want to haunt?
Well, if I die before you, I would want to haunt you.
Are you going to try and scare me?
Oh, I'm going to spill your coffee all the time just to remind you of me.
You dead and no coffee. My worst nightmare.
Oh, really? Is that your worst nightmare?
Michael?
Well?
I honestly don't know what I'd do without coffee.